I don't know about you, but I'm getting sick of companies slapping their AI sticker on old features and claiming they have AI agents. It's a real problem called agent washing, and Gartner estimated earlier this year that only 130 of the thousands of agentic AI vendors actually have a real agent to offer. In this video, I'll show you how to protect yourself from getting duped, featuring some well-known examples. And if you stick around, we'll cover why even having a real AI agent is no guarantee of success. I'm David, I'm helping Kevin bring you more great tutorials like this one. Let's dive in. First, we need to get on the same page about what an AI agent is. Now, one of the first mentions of agents was in the book Artificial Intelligence: A Modern Approach. They said an agent is anything that can be viewed as perceiving its environment through sensors and acting upon that environment through actuators. What does that actually mean? Well, perceiving its environment means the agent can understand its current context, including understanding a prompt or reading data on the web. It then has to reason about that context to figure out what to do next. And then acting upon that environment means that it takes action. It's not just a chatbot that spits out an email draft, it actually sends the email. But we need to go deeper because this definition taken out of context basically means most software. So there's good consensus among major players like Amazon, Anthropic, Google, and Microsoft that agents have five characteristics. Most important, they're autonomous. You don't need to tell them step by step how to do something. Second, they take observable action like we just talked about. And third, they perceive their environment. Fourth, they adapt from feedback. For example, a customer service agent that gets told its tone is too harsh should fix that for future customers. And finally, they are proactive. They can see there's work to do and start it without being prompted. Okay, let's use a simple example to make this clear. ChatGPT Deep Research. This tool helps you learn about topics with collegiate level analysis. Now, OpenAI claimed that Deep Research is an agent. But how does that hold up against our definition? First, yes, it is autonomous. You can type in a short prompt and it figures out exactly how to search for information, which web pages to read, and how to combine all the information it learned into a final paper. Next, it doesn't take action. It just responds through text. Third, it's perceptive by definition. It has to know how to research the topic and how to get that information into its system. Fourth, it's somewhat adaptive. It asks you for input before starting research and adapts to that input within a single request, but it's not clear how it learns over time if it does. And finally, it's not proactive either. It just responds when you prompt it. Okay, so with this definition, is ChatGPT Deep Research an agent or not? You know what? It actually doesn't matter. What does matter is that when a company calls their product an agent, you understand exactly what you get according to these five characteristics. Now, Deep Research doesn't take action and it's not proactive, but I'm not expecting it to. It's still a valuable tool. So when a company says that they have an agent, don't assume that it has all of these qualities. Here's an example from last year called Presto Automation. They make AI voice tools for drive-through restaurants, and they claimed to eliminate the need for human order taking altogether. But this was so fraudulent that the SEC filed charges against them for misleading customers, stating that the vast majority of drive-throughs with their tech still required humans. And that's the problem with a lot of AI agents. You think you're getting a human-like partner trained to do an amazing job, and it turns out it takes even more work to manage them than it did to do the work in the first place. They just fail the autonomy test. Now, that was last year, and I can't comment on their capabilities now. So let's take a look at some more popular AI agents and put them to the test. First up is the sponsor of today's video, QuickBooks Online. If you're an accountant or small business owner, QuickBooks Online is a great tool to manage your finances. They just released several AI agents this summer, so let's take a look at one to see how it measures up. This is the accounting agent. It auto-categorizes your expenses so you know what money you don't have to pay taxes on. It's a win-win. So let's check the scorecard. Is it autonomous? Yes, it carries out a complex task and I don't need to tell it how to do its job. Does it take action? Yes, it categorizes those expenses for me. That's clearly observable. Number three, is it perceptive? Yes, it knows how to find and read my expenses. Number four, is it adaptive? Yes, if I categorize an expense differently from how it chooses, then next time it'll follow my choice. And last, is it proactive? Yes, all of this is done for me before I even log in. So the accounting agent passes the agent test, and they've got several other agents designed to help you get paid more quickly and not miss any detail on your finances. Check out the link in the description below to get a discount off your first 3 months of QuickBooks Online. We'll take on two more, starting with Microsoft Copilot Studio, where you can create your own AI agents. We'll run this through the same scorecard, starting with number one, is it autonomous? Yes, you can make your agents carry out complex tasks. For example, here, I want it to help me prep for meetings on my calendar by sending me a daily digest of all the people that I'm meeting with. Two, is it perceptive? Yes, it has to read those appointments on my calendar to see the attendees. Three, does it take action? Yes, sending me an email is considered an action, so that's a yes. Four, is it adaptive? This is possible, but you either have to build it out yourself, which can get pretty tricky, or you have to build what's called an agent flow and get an input from a human. And last, is it proactive? Yes, you can set up triggers for your agent beyond just a user prompt. Last up is custom GPTs. These are basically versions of ChatGPT designed to handle one specific task really well. Some people call these agents, so let's see if they measure up. At this point, you know the drill. The scorecard starts with number one, are they autonomous? Well, you can carry out pretty complex tasks with them, so that's a yes. Here's an example of one that writes a LinkedIn post promoting videos that I make based on the transcript. Number two, are they adaptive? Well, somewhat. See, with this GPT, I can feed changes to the canvas to help it understand what to do next, but it won't preserve those preferences for the next session unless I do extra work. Number three, are they perceptive? Yes, they pretty much have to be to notice my changes. Number four, do they take action? Well, they can, but you have to be somewhat technical to get it done right. But yes, this is true. Number five, finally, are they proactive? No, they're not. So they have some characteristics of an agent, but not all of them. Now there's actually a huge gap in this scorecard that I've danced around this entire video. And that is the agent even useful? Agents can check all of these boxes, but because they're based on technology that relies on chance and probability, you have to be very, very sure that they do their job well. Because businesses don't like chance, they want reliability. So if you're tasked with buying or building software with an agent in it, you better make sure it does what it says it does. And consider this if you're building an agent. If you don't need to interpret or generate text or images like ChatGPT does, and you don't need a dynamic workflow engine where the steps of the task might change from session to session, then you might not need an agent. Consider using an alternate technology. Now, if you enjoyed today's video, make sure to give us a like. And before you go, check out the QuickBooks Online deal in the description below. Kevin and I would really appreciate it. We'll see you in the next one.